Amazing campaign moment or merely planned stagecraft? At a Hillary Clinton event in suburban Philadelphia, a teenage girl in the audience asked the perfect question to highlight Donald Trump's mistreatment of women. Watch.
Hi, Madam Secretary. I'm Brennan, and I'm 15 years old. At my school, body image is a really big issue for girls my age. I see with my own eyes the damage Donald Trump does when he talks about women and how they look. As the first female president, how would you undo some of that damage and help girls understand that they are so much more than just what they look like?
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
So the exchange got picked up everywhere, including the New York Times, which identified the girl as the daughter of a Democratic Pennsylvania state representative. He's a state senator, and said that he had helped shape the question, but didn't name him or see a reason to further connect the dots. Well, as you can well imagine, plenty of media outlets took that fact and they ran with it. They accused the state senator, Dalen Leach, and his daughter, Brennan, of being paid plants, something that the Clinton campaign has been accused of in the past. Matter of fact, here's Megyn Kelly's take.
New questions about whether or not the Clinton campaign may be planting questions at her events.
Little editorializing there with the facial expression. The outrage and backlash overwhelmed the original story and all but obliterated his actual content, part of the endless inside politics narratives that turned the whole process into a circus. But here's the thing. Everybody did this without ever asking the girl or her father. So I'm about to rectify that. Joining me now is Pennsylvania State Senator Dalen Leach and his 15-year-old daughter, Brennan. Brennan, are you an actress?
Look, if you consider a couple school plays and a video for my friend's mom acting, then yes, I love theater. I've been passionate about it since I was a little kid. But in no way was I approached by Hillary's campaign or asked to ask a question. She did not know I was going to ask a question. She didn't know what I was going to say at all. So, I mean, it was by chance. Unfortunately, I had never met Elizabeth Banks either. So, completely unrelated. And I've never been involved in both at the same time.
Did Dad write it for you? Did he prod you in any way?
Not at all. I mean, this is an issue that's really important to me. Body image is something that's really relevant to girls my age. And when a public icon like Donald Trump is calling women fat and ugly pigs and, you know, judging them only based off of how they look, it really does affect us. So I wanted to write this question. I came up with it. Obviously, if you think you're going to speak in front of the future president, you have your parents look over it and help you edit it. And I practiced it a couple times. And I mean, he definitely helped me sort of compose myself and fix my wording. But other than that, it was my idea. And I came up with it on my own.
Dalen, the fact that she was able to ask the first question is causing some people to say, well, the whole thing must have been a setup.
Well, not what happened is, you know, when you do something like this and they open it up for questions, often people are reluctant to raise their hands. The first question is sort of awkward. Once a number of people have asked questions, you have 20, 30 people at a time raising their hands. She opened it up. Brennan raised her hand a little bit. She was the only one to raise her hand. Actually, my wife, Jennifer, took her elbow and raised it a little higher. Elizabeth Banks, you were sitting right in the front row in a special section for elected officials. Mm-hmm. I wasn't even sitting next to her. And Elizabeth Banks called on her, and it, simply because she raised her hand. There's no grand conspiracy here.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know that this week there were revelations that Steve Harvey had shared his questions with her in advance, with Secretary Clinton in advance, and so it perpetuates this whole idea that what we view and think, Dalen, is spontaneous often is not the case. Mm-hmm. You can see how this story got caught up in that narrative.
Well, yeah, but I mean, I wish people like Megyn Kelly and others, it's mostly been the right-wing media, you know, would have at least fact-checked, done journalism 101, called us and asked us about this, because there was no planning. There's all kinds of stuff in crazy media outlets about how, you know, we were paid and all that sort of thing. None of that is remotely true. This was a spontaneous question from a girl who cares deeply about an issue, and that's all it was. And, you know, basic journalism would have uncovered that. In fact, Snopes, which investigates rumors like this, did investigate this and found that this wasn't a plant. But we have been getting so much sort of outright hate from Trump supporters. I've gotten over 30,000 Twitter messages, all kinds of stuff on Facebook, threats, really horrific suggestions about Brennan. I mean, you know, at some point, human decency should take over.
Hey, Brennan, quick final question on a very serious subject. Not that this isn't, but I know that you lost a friend and that was part of your mindset in fashioning this question. Speak to that.
Well, you know, it's not my place to sort of talk about that and who that person was. I was not authorized to do that. But yes, I mean, it's not just me. It's not just my experience. When I asked that question, I was speaking on behalf of, you know, middle and high schoolers all over the country. You know, it really does damage us. This is our most insecure time in life. And to have someone that we're supposed to look up to be, you know, insulting women, and as you saw on the tapes today, really just brutal harassment, it's horrible. And it does trickle to us. I don't think a lot of adults realize how much it affects their kids and the younger generation. So a lot of the other issues don't affect me, but I know that this issue is really important and it's not talked about as much as it should be. So talking to Hillary was really important to me, and I'm really glad I got the opportunity.
Brennan and Dalen Leach, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
Thank you.